Hi, my name is Vijay Keswani, and I'll be presenting our paper on dialect diversity in text summarization on Twitter. This is joint work with my advisor, Professor Lisa Salis at Yale University. With wide-scale adoption of social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, has helped induce diverse online dialogue and led to centralized global discussions on a variety of topics. The prominent example that we study in this paper is Twitter, which saw around 350 million monthly active users in 2020. These users posted around 500 million tweets per day, and the posts were written in more than 50 different languages. Even within English, posts on Twitter are written in many different dialects, and the dialect diversity of Twitter has even encouraged linguists to use Twitter posts to study regional dialect variation. And these are just some of the recent papers on this topic. In our paper, we study the problem of text summarization in the context of Twitter. An extractive text summarization algorithm aims to condense a large number of sentences or a document into a small representative sample. And the main goals of extractive summarization algorithm is to one, preserve the primary topics of the document, or in other words, to preserve the meaning of the document, and secondly, to maintain representational diversity, as in all the major viewpoints in the document should be expressed in the summary as well. Some examples of standard popular text summarization algorithms are TF-IDF, LexRank, TextRank, or even Twitter Search Bar, which uses things even beyond just the set of posts, such as user network or the time of the post and so on, and is relatively beyond the scope of our paper. But the main question that we investigate is that given the diversity of posts in Twitter with respect to dialect, do standard summarization algorithms generate summaries that preserve the dialect diversity of the original set of posts? The first part of our paper empirically questions or tries to empirically investigate this question. And what we look at are standard extractive summarization algorithms, which take as input a set of sentences or Twitter posts in this case, the desired size of summary k, and return a k-size summary containing a subset of the sentences from original set. The algorithms we analyze for this part are TF-IDF, hybrid TF-IDF, which are frequency-based algorithms that quantify importance of sentences by word frequency, LexRank and TextRank, which are graph-based algorithms that quantify importance by centrality in the pairwise similarity graph, centroid word2vec, which also uses word2vec features to quantify the centrality of sentences, but also has an additional non-redundancy component in the sense that it tries to greedily add non-redundant sentences to the summary. Maximum marginal relevance score algorithm, which also uses TF-IDF scores and tries to ensure that the summary is non-redundant. And SummaRunner, which technically is a supervised summarization algorithm, but we use the version that's pre-trained on the CNN Daily Mail dataset. The data set we'll use for this dialect analysis is Twitter AE, which contains around 102,000 posts written in African American English dialect and around 1.1 million posts written in standard English dialect. The methodology we follow for this empirical analysis is that we extract collections from Twitter AE data set that contain a specific keyword, and this keyword occurs in a non-trivial number of AE and standard English posts. We generate summaries using the summarization algorithms mentioned in the previous slide, and we report the fraction of AE posts in the generated summaries. And the results are quite negative. What we observe, at least in this setting, is that all algorithms other than TF-IDF return summaries that have a smaller fraction of AE posts than the original collection for different summary sizes, as can be seen from the first plot. This observation remains same even when we vary the fraction of AE posts in the original collection from 0 to 1, in the sense that AE dialect is always underrepresented, and it also remains same for different data sets with different protected attribute features. So given these negative results, we question whether we can design frameworks that exploit the utility of these summarization algorithms, which is pretty much well established at this point, but at the same time generate dialect diverse summaries. Before moving to our algorithm, prior work in the field of pair summarization mainly uses two approaches. The first is to use feature-based non-redundancy approaches, which basically tries to ensure that the sentences in the summary are not very similar to each other. Two examples of these approach are MMR and determinator point processes. But the main disadvantage of this approach is that it has been shown that non-redundancy does not imply diversity with respect to protected attribute, like dialect in this case. And we pretty much saw that in the previous slide as well, because MMR did not return dialect diverse summaries either. The second approach is to use dialect labels to form constraints on the summary. And this is indeed the approach used by FairSum, which is a fair text summarization algorithms by Dash et al. The main disadvantage of this approach is that it requires explicit access to dialect labels, which for a platform like Twitter, dialect labels do not exist. And automated dialect inference can be very difficult because social media dialects are always evolving, and the sheer number of dialects makes this task of learning a different model for every dialect very, very cumbersome. So our main point of focus is that can we design methods that can generate dialect diverse summaries but do not require dialect labels for the entire collection? And our proposed algorithm for this question is the following. Any summarization algorithm follows this basic structure that it has a collection, it is given a collection S, which passes through a summarization algorithm A, say TF-IDF or LexRank or TextRank or any of those algorithms that we saw in the previous slide. And this algorithm A generates an array with utility scores for each post. And ranking with respect to this score will give a summary, but it can possibly be biased. To address the bias, we introduce a diversity control set. A diversity control set is a small set of sentences, say 20 sentences, with equal number of posts written from all relevant dialects. So something like 20 sentences with 10 written in AE dialect and 10 written in standard English dialect. To incorporate the diversity of this control set, we first construct a pairwise similarity matrix. Each entry of this matrix quantifies the similarity between an element in the control set and the collection S. To combine the diversity component from the diversity control set and the utility component from the summarization algorithm A, we simply compute a linear combination of scores from these two parts in this manner. And to finally return a summary, we sort each row and return equal number of top posts from each row. So this score incorporates the diversity score from the diversity control set as well as the utility score from algorithm A. And this simple approach ensures that the summary will be dialect diverse in a similar manner as the control set T, and at the same time will incorporate the score from the summarization algorithm A. Results of this approach over the Twitter AE dataset, specifically for the setting where we were summarizing topic-specific collections, are the following. So we use centroid Vertuvec as the base algorithm A. We use alpha equal to 0.5 in the previous algorithm. We use cosine distance as the similarity metric, and the cosine distance are computed with respect to features generated using Vertuvec. The performance is of our post-processing approach is relatively much better than the base algorithm centroid Vertuvec, Indeed, you can see that in most cases, centroid were to work with alpha equal to 0.5, which is denoted by this green star, is much better than the just centroid were to work, which is denoted by this blue star, and is also relatively closer to the original data set for the keyword. Increasing alpha obviously leads to more dialect diverse summaries, but it will lead to further deviation from the summary generated by the base algorithm A. We see that the results are similar even for other data sets. Our second analysis was with respect to the Claritin data set, which contains around 4,000 posts about the drug Claritin. The protected attribute is the gender of the user who posted the tweet in this case. In this case, we also perform a quality evaluation of our summaries using Loge scores with respect to manually generated reference summaries. The table provides both the Loge scores as well as the percentage of posts by men in the summary of different algorithms. The first observation is consistent with the one that we observed in case of Twitter AE dataset, that all standard summarization algorithms generate gender imbalance summaries. On the other hand, our framework using any base algorithm A generates more gender balanced summaries than the summaries of A. In fact, when we use centroid word to vec as A and alpha equal to 0.5, the recall scores are similar to the recall scores of fair sum, which explicitly uses dialect labels for fairness. So we see that we don't lose much by using this post-processing framework and the control sets. To conclude the talk, it's important to note that we just did an empirical analysis of these summarization algorithms. And the bias in the summaries is likely related to the structural aspects that the algorithms use to generate summaries. But this simple analysis shows that the dialects can differ in structure. For example, TF-IDF uses frequency, word frequencies, and the average length of posts of AE dialect are much smaller than the average length of posts written in standard English dialect. We do not directly address these structural differences, but we use diversity control sets to ensure that all structurally different dialects are appropriately represented. Another important part of our framework is diversity control set. And while we propose an algorithm to automatically construct such sets, we argue that it is important that the choice is context dependent and the composition should be subject to community assessment and audits. Finally, other directions where future work can be pursued include using better similarity metrics and embeddings, as well as ways to evaluate summaries from extractive algorithms and factual and evaluations that quantify factual similarity between manual summaries and automatically generated summaries. That's all for this talk, but feel free to come by the Q&A sessions and discuss this paper further. Thank you.